Now, let's make it Halloween. Okay, we got it. I'm going to try to do this, okay? As much as I can. Halloween was just passed, right? October 31st. Now, we know that Halloween is the festival of the dead, right? And see, these holidays, they have no root where we come from.
Right.
In Africa, in Asia.
Right.
All of these holidays that we celebrate, their root is in Europe. And it comes from Europe at a time where the Europeans had no knowledge.
Wow.
See, the Europeans were in the Dark Ages, and when they got ready to, like, explore the world, not when they got ready, when we actually went there and civilized them and shared with them the knowledge that we had, and that gave them the ability to explore the world. Y'all with me?
Wow.
And they came among us. Before that, they believed in spirits and demons and ghosts and goblins. They had no scientific reason for things that took place,
right?
So if you were sick, they would just put leeches on your body, and the leeches would suck your blood, and they thought that the leeches would suck the sickness out of you.
Wow.
Because they didn't have any scientists. They learned that from us. Are y'all with me? So now, so this festival was during that time. So when we follow these holidays, it has nothing to do with black people. Wow. The only reason we celebrate them is because we were brought in slavery. And whatever the slave master celebrated, what? We were forced to celebrate those same holidays. I personally believe that if there was a Ku Klux Klan holiday tomorrow, and black people got the day off, and we could barbecue. Well, girl, what you gonna do for Ku Klux Klan today? Well, I'm gonna barbecue with some chicken, man. I'm coming over, you gonna have some ribs on the grill? Yeah, man, I just love the Ku Klux Klan. That's how, I'm just telling you. Because we just want a day off work, is that right? Unemployed and want a day off work, I don't understand. So now, the Celts and the Anglo-Saxons, right, who are white from Europe, their new year began on November 1st, which was the end of summer, right? And they thought that the sun was dying. So they would set these huge fires in Europe, bonfires, right? And they thought that by setting these fires, they could bring the sun back to life. Are y'all with me? Well, we know that that's crazy. Now, so they had a festival of the dead because in the winter the earth dies, right? So Halloween was a Celtic and Anglo-Saxon festival of the dead. The Druids they celebrated or worshiped the god of death. And on October 31st, this god of death gathered all the evil spirits together, right? And they would be reincarnated as animals. So this is during this time, what the Europeans would do, they would take dead animals and wear them on their head, right?
Mm-hmm.
And they thought that by wearing the dead ox or the dead cow or the dead pig or whatever, wear these dead animals on their head, that they would scare away the evil spirits, right? Mm-hmm. And they would go throughout the countryside, the poor people, the homeless, would go throughout the countryside and beg, right? So some people would beg food for the homeless, right? And it would be good food. Others would bake food for the homeless, and they put dead rats on the inside, blood on the inside, something to poison the food on the inside, right? And they would give it to them. So this is where the trick-or-treating came from. Some people would give you good food, and some people would give you something that was poisonous. And they would give their food to the homeless people that were begging in Europe. Are y'all with me?
Yes, sir.
So now, what happened? In 43 AD, the Romans conquered the Celts, right? And they merged two of their gods together. The Celtic god was Feralia. The Roman god was Pomona. Are y'all with me?
Yes, sir.
So they merged their celebration. Pomona was the goddess of fruit in ancient Rome. She wore a crown of apples on her head. So now, every Halloween, they have a thing where you bob for apples, right?
Yeah.
And you stick your head in a barrel with five other people. Snot and slob coming all out your mouth, right? And they put a couple of apples in there, and you stick your head in the water, and you try to catch the apple in your mouth with everybody slob and spit, right? In there with you. Now, I bought apples before, I'm not gonna lie. But, you know, before I became a Muslim at the boys' club, yeah, I did do that. But see, we do these things and have no idea where they come from. Are y'all with me?
Yes.
So now, when Christianity took over Rome, the Pope compromised with the pagans because he wanted the pagans to become a part of Christianity. Y'all with me? So he decided to make November 1st, All Souls Day, and the day before November 1st, which was October 31st, would be All Hallows Eve, or the contraction is Halloween. Y'all understand? Yeah. He didn't change the practice, he just incorporated the practice into Christianity. Which is, you know, what Caucasians have done. They take the name of God, right? And they use his name to shield whatever evil they want to do. Are y'all with me? Don't get too mad because we do the same thing, right? I mean, you know, they say, well, you know, if God didn't want people to be gay, why would he make them that? Why would he make me like that, right? And you watch the TV, yeah, it kind of makes sense, right? And you hear the brothers, well, see, what happened was, see, if God didn't want a brother smoking weed, you know what I'm saying? Why is the weed on earth? You know what I'm saying? What do you put it here for? Right? I mean, but we don't use that logic with other things, do we? This dog do in the park? Hey, well, you know, it's here, it's on earth. Maybe I should eat this, or maybe I should smoke it. We don't use that same measure, right? Now, we said, well, see, if God didn't want us to, you know, have all these women, you know, then why is there so many of them? You know what I'm saying? I mean, he wasn't one of them either. Right? So don't get too mad at white people, because they trained us very well to do the same exact thing, right? Never follow God, and then when something bad happens in our life, we blame God, right? It's just smoking crack. Grandmama died, now we blame God. You understand? Just shut up the block. Cousin got shot last week, now we mad at God at the funeral. Why would God let this happen? Well, what happened when you shut the little 4-year-old boy drinking Kool-Aid? Right. You understand? God catches a lot of flack. So now, that's Halloween. It's a celebration of the dead. It has nothing to do with Jesus. Nothing to do with God. So after Halloween,